You may have heard that we've shared some recent updates to our Teams product based on feedback that all of you have shared on how we can make it easier and more powerful for you in the classroom. It's amazing to think that this powerful communications and collaboration tool just released 2 years ago, and it's incredible to see experiences. Now, one example comes to us from Jen Padernal from the Philippines. She teaches in De La Salle DE University's night school, which provides free quality education for adults, and Teams enables them to share wherever they are. So Jen's going to share us 13 tips for how we can make it easier for all of you to use Teams in your classroom. Take it away, Jen.
Hi, everyone. My name is Jen, and I'm from De La Salle University, Das Marinas, from the Philippines. I teach there. De La Salle University is a Filipino Catholic university that's located in the Philippines, and it offers like a lot of different programs from higher ed to junior high school. And one of the programs being offered in that university is what we call the DLSUD Night College, which supports the mission of the school of teaching minds, touching hearts, and transforming lives. So the students in the DLSUD Night College are all working students, and our primary objective is to give them like a quality education that will help them graduate and have a better future. So these are the underprivileged students in the province, so we are like supporting them so that they can continue going to school. So I'm a volunteer, and all of the teachers there are volunteer, and we don't really get paid for the volunteer teaching job that we do, because we love the students, we love the school, we love the mission, and we love education. So that's the reason why we're volunteering. I've been a volunteer for like 9 years already, and one of the things that helped me in my volunteer teaching job is when I use cool tools, digital tools in the classroom. So aside from teaching, I'm also a professional learning development specialist in Cypher Learning. I'm also their e-learning global director for e-learning integration. And I travel all throughout Asia Pacific region training teachers in K-12 on how to use technology in the classroom. And one of the tools that I teach them is a Microsoft Teams. I'm using it in my classroom now because it helps me a lot. There's a lot of these advantages that we can get from Microsoft Teams. For one, it's inclusive. Everyone will have access to teaching and learning tools anytime, anywhere. So Microsoft Teams allows everyone to have access to education and information anytime, anywhere. Another cool stuff about Microsoft Teams, it's a safe environment for everyone to collaborate. So I also love that it amplifies the students' voice so that they share whatever information that they have or ideas that they have. And I also love that it makes my classroom borderless. I can be anywhere, anytime, and I can still teach. My student can still participate in a discussion. And it's really cool. It's like giving everyone access to education literally anytime, anywhere. I'd like to share a little bit of my experience when we started using Microsoft Teams. It was like a little bit funny and challenging because this is the first time that my students are using Microsoft Teams, and everyone is getting the hang of it. But once they get connected, and I started the discussion, everyone was literally so engaged in the discussion. They were participating even more engaged, I would say, than my face-to-face class. Because during a face-to-face class, people will be like, the students will be so shy to raise their hands and participate in the discussion. But with Microsoft Teams, they feel like they're in their zone, like they're in the social media platform and just participating in any discussion. So it allows my students to be even more creative and more participative. So you might be wondering how I get started and how I prepared my students for this. Since I know that this is going to be their first time, I've already asked them to download the app so that it's easier for them to get connected whenever and wherever they are. So I also make sure that they have their Office 365 working, and the schedule is also being posted in the LMS that we're using in our university. All right, so I also created groups in Microsoft Teams to make sure that my students can collaborate with whatever activities that we have. And they can easily share files, and they can easily communicate with each other. So now what I'm gonna do next is to give you my lucky 13 tips on how you can get started with Microsoft Teams. First tip, and the first thing that you need to do, is to download the app, both for mobile and desktop. So this is really helpful because even if you're teaching in elementary, high school, or even in a university, with this app, you can have access to the information and the class anytime, anywhere. Next tip, you can also use Microsoft Teams for blended virtual classes. So what you can do is you discuss face-to-face, and then you continue the discussion virtually using Microsoft Teams. You might also want to use Microsoft Teams for flipped classes. So it works pretty well, especially in the middle school or elementary or high school. So what you can do is upload all the videos, all the photos that you need to use before you even meet them in class. And then right after that, when you meet them in class, what you can do is to just facilitate the activities that's related to all of the lessons and videos that you have uploaded in Microsoft Teams. It's also going to be cool if you can use the tabs area to add additional app that you can use to get your class more engaged. I added Flipgrid, and I think you'll love that tool. So if they want to use a method of participating using a video, add a tab, add Flipgrid or any other apps that you want to use. It's a lot of apps that's available in the tabs area of Teams. So you can use that. Then you can also create channels based on different topics. So it will help a lot. You can continue the discussion even after the class with that discussion forum. You also want to create a channel for discussion forums. So these are topics that they can just post anything, any idea that they want. And for students who are absent in class, probably because they got sick or something came up, you might want to create a channel for remedial classes. So you can upload everything, all lessons that a student have missed, and they will just access it from Microsoft Teams. And this is very important. Every session that you have in Microsoft Teams, you have to record it so that your students can have access to it even after the virtual class. You might also want to use the general channel for general announcements that you have. Everybody can see it, everyone can have access to it, and they get information literally accessible anytime, anywhere. I also want you to try and let the students know that they can make use of the notes section so that when you're doing your virtual class, it will be easier for them to take notes of the important ideas and key learning during the virtual session using the notes part of Microsoft Teams. And if you want your students to be more engaged collaborating, simply create a collaboration activity channel for your students, and they can easily share files and communicate with each other. And last, my lucky 13th tip, use Microsoft OneNote in your Microsoft Teams. It's built in Microsoft Teams, and it's really easy to set up. All right, so that's my lucky 13 tips. Microsoft Teams has really helped me a lot in transforming the way that I teach and transforming the way that my students are learning. It literally gave them like a really good learning experience. So if I were you, start learning Microsoft Teams today by going to education.microsoft.com. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jen. Those are great tips to share, and I hope all of you can leverage the power of Teams to make not only remote learning possible, but bring great collaboration and communication across your students, across classrooms. I hope you're taking advantage of Teams and learning from Jen's tips. Be a change maker with Teams.